Do you hear it? Do you feel it? God's heartbeat of love. God is love. Before the creation of the world, God was living in perfect harmony as three persons in one. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Out of their love, the world and mankind were created.
Fruit was eaten, a cosmic battle between good and evil began. The fight was over the eternal souls of men. Disguised as a snake in the garden, Satan showed himself to be the ultimate enemy of mankind. But God had a plan. He foretold the coming of one who would defeat Satan. God said to the serpent, "I will cause hostility between you and the woman, and between your offspring and her offspring. He will crush your head, and you will strike his heel." Savior of mankind came much later in a way that no one expected. God chose to fulfill the prophecy through an ordinary woman in Nazareth named Mary. God showed how much he loved us by sending his one and only Son into the world so that we might have eternal life through him.
We will not be shaken.
Trust in the Lord with my heart and your joy in the world forever. submit to sorrow. Our joy is coming in the morning. In the morning.
The time came for the baby to be born. Mary gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloth and placed him in a manger.
Now, out in the fields of Bethlehem, there were shepherds watching their sheep at night. And then an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all people. Today a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
So the shepherds hurried off to find Mary, Joseph, and the baby, and they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child. All who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.
Oh, God. just love them. I just love them. So I die just to love them. I just love them. I just love them. I just.
Christ was born because he loved us. The King of Kings and Lord of Lords humbled himself and became a baby. Outside of a few shepherds, no one really seemed to notice. However, there were magi from the east who studied the stars. One star they found was guiding them towards a king. So they traveled far and brought gifts to honor and worship him.
Wise men following the brightest star down in Bethlehem. They came far for the coming again of the one that's ever been. And when they found him, they fell onto the ground and join the angels shouting, singing all around him. Sing hallelujah, hallelujah, that's what the angels cry. Hallelujah, hallelujah, precious little child. Hallelujah, hallelujah, sound of the angels' joy. Hallelujah, hallelujah, little baby boy. With us, and he's the only one that's ever been. So when they found him, we fell onto the ground and joined the angels shouting, singing all around him. Sing hallelujah, hallelujah. That's what the angels cry. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Precious little child. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Jesus didn't come just to be a baby. He came to serve and offer up his life for the sins of the world. Adam's one sin brought condemnation for everyone. But Christ's one act of righteousness offers everyone a new life and right relationship with God. Do you think Mary knew the price her son would have to pay?
Mary, did you know your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you delivered will soon deliver you.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man?
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand?
Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod?
Did you notice that the whole song is a series of questions? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will someday walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know? My question for us tonight is this. Did you know? Did you know that the Lord Jesus Christ's ministry only lasted 3 years? And yet 2,000 plus years have gone by. And millions upon millions upon millions of people every day in every continent around the world worship him. Did you know that the Lord Jesus Christ is uniquely different than any other person that's ever lived or ever will live? There's a lot of reasons why he's unique. But let me give you five, just five, very quickly. First, Jesus is unique because he was born of a virgin. Let me ask you a question. Anybody been born of a virgin in here? Jesus is unique. Matter of fact, that's one of the miracles of Christmas. Look what the Bible says. In Matthew chapter 1, verse 23, it says, "The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, God with us." And that verse takes us to the second reason. Jesus claimed that he was God. Listen to what he said in John chapter 14. "Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father." And then in John 10, he said, "I and the Father are one." He declared that he was equal with the Father, with God. I remind you that the only reason that they were able to crucify Jesus Christ is because he claimed to be God. Third reason why Jesus is unique, because he claimed he himself had the authority to forgive us of sin. He himself had the authority to forgive us of our sin. Look what the Bible says in Matthew chapter 9. "Some men brought him," meaning Jesus, "a paralyzed man lying on a mat. When Jesus saw their faith, he said to the man, 'Take heart, son, your sins are forgiven.' At this, some of the teachers of the law said to themselves, 'This fellow is blaspheming.' Knowing their thoughts, Jesus said, 'Why do you entertain evil thoughts in your hearts? Which is easier to say, your sins are forgiven, or to say, get up and walk? But I want you to know that the Son of Man has authority on earth to forgive sins.' So he said to the paralyzed man, 'Get up, take your mat, and go home.' Then the man got up and went home." Jesus is unique, born of a virgin, claimed to be God, and said he has all authority to forgive us of our sins. And number four, Jesus is unique because of how he taught the scriptures, what he said about salvation. His message about salvation is uniquely different than any other message that has ever been or ever will be. Every other religion in the world, if you study them, which I have, except Christianity, teaches that you have to be good enough to approach God. You have to be good enough to get to heaven. The question is, when do you know that you're good enough? Jesus Christ taught something totally different. He said that salvation is a gift that you receive by faith. And by the way, the gift is himself, Jesus Christ. He is the Savior of the world. This is what it says in John 3:16. "For God so loved the world that he gave his only son. For God so loved us. For God so loved you that he gave," there's the gift, "he gave his son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have what? Eternal life." So that you can know that your sins are forgiven and that heaven is your home. I love it that the young people tonight, they definitely demonstrated that Jesus Christ was born of a virgin. Most Christmas shows leave Jesus in the manger, in the cradle. And I thank God they didn't do that tonight. They showed us the cross. Jesus Christ went from the cradle to the cross. And he died on that cross, it says, for our sins. And why did he have to do that? Listen to what it says in Romans 3:23. It says that all of us have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. What does that mean? That means that not one of us in this room is perfect. We've all broken the laws of God. We all know that in our hearts, in our minds. We know that we have said things and done things that we wish we would have never said or ever did, but we did them and we cannot rewind the tape. We broke the laws of God. And because we broke the laws of God, it says this in the scriptures, in Romans chapter 6, verse 23. It says that the wages of sin is death. Wages is referring to the consequences of us breaking God's laws. And what the Bible says is that when we break God's laws, in other words, we have two things in common, everybody. All of us have broken the laws of God, and all of us will die. For the wages of sin is death. Because we broke God's laws, we're going to die. We're going to die. And if you die in your sins, then you're lost forever. But that's what motivated the Lord Jesus Christ. He so loved us. He so loved you that he was willing to sacrifice himself on the cross on your behalf and mine. And by dying on the cross, he satisfied the law. The law required that someone die, and he died in your place and mine. And when he died, he paid in full what the law required. and he satisfied the law, and he paid our debt. And Jesus to this day has all authority that can forgive you of your sin. But what about death? We're all going to die. We all know we've blown it, but we're all going to die because of it. What did he do about that? Takes us to the fifth point. What makes him uniquely different than any other person that will ever live? He was resurrected from the dead. Listen to what Jesus Christ said. He said, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die. Not only did Jesus Christ make this claim, but he backed it up and he walked out of the grave. Matter of fact, you could go to every gravesite where every other religious leader has ever been buried, and they're still in the grave. When you go to the gravesite of Jesus Christ, it's an empty tomb. Why? Because he walked out of the grave, and he overcame sin, and he overcame death. And the Bible says anybody who calls upon his name, he has all power and authority to forgive you of your sin and to give to you eternal life. That's what Jesus Christ did. That is the great miracle of Christmas and Easter that we celebrate every year. See, the Bible says, for God so loved you that he gave his only son. That's the gift. That whoever believes in him, how do you receive the gift? You believe. And he says this, you will not perish, but you will have eternal life. And Jesus Christ is the only one that can do that for you. And believing is as simple as ABC. A, you admit that you broke God's laws. B, you believe what Jesus Christ did on the cross and in the grave he did for you. And what he did in the grave and on the cross is enough for you. In other words, you can't earn it. You can't work for it. It's a gift. It's a gift. And we're talking about having a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. And this gift has been given to us. And how do you receive this gift? By faith. So A, you admit. B, you believe. You believe what Jesus Christ did for you. You know, people come to me often and say this, Pastor Ed, what must I do to get saved? What do I got to do? And I always tell them, you're too late. It's already been done. Jesus Christ is the one who died on the cross. He's the one that walked out of the grave, not you. You can't work for it. You can't buy it. It's a gift. Jesus Christ, you're getting there based on his finished work. Do you believe that? If you do, then what you need to do is see. You commit yourself to Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ, tonight, we're not introducing you to a religion. We're not introducing you to a set of rules, regulations, or even traditions. We're introducing you to the person of Jesus Christ who's alive, who's living, and wants to walk into your life tonight. He walked out of that grave for the purpose of loving you, forgiving you, and having a relationship with you. And if you want to ask Jesus Christ into your heart tonight, you can. He's here tonight. He wants to forgive you. Look right here. You did not come here by chance. You might never get this moment again. And Jesus wants you to know that he loves you, he wants to forgive you, and he wants a relationship with you. I'm going to give you that opportunity right here and now. I'm going to ask that everyone bow your heads and close your eyes. And if you want to know Jesus Christ as your Savior, you want to know that you are a child of God and you're part of the family of God, you want to know that your sins are forgiven and heaven's going to be your home, then just pray this prayer with me. The prayer doesn't save you, Jesus does. But with your eyes closed, see Jesus coming right up to you because he is. And he wants to have a relationship with you. You know, when I made a commitment to my wife, I was all in. When I said I was going to get married to her, I did it publicly. And so did she. And we were both all in on that relationship. Listen, Jesus is all in on his relationship to you. If you want to be in on him, you want to have a relationship with him, tell him tonight. Say, Jesus, I want you to forgive me. I believe what you did on the cross, you did for me. And you walked out of that grave, and because you walked out of that grave, you have all power and authority to forgive me and give to me eternal life. Tomorrow's promise to no one. Tonight, Lord, I want to know you as my Savior and my Lord. You want to pray that prayer with me? Pray this prayer. Lord Jesus, thank you that you died on the cross and walked out of the grave for me. I ask you to forgive me of my sin. And now I turn my life over to you. And I want to begin a relationship with you tonight. I want you to be my Savior and my Lord. and I'm asking you to change my life. I'm turning from the way I've been living, and I'm turning to you. And I'm asking you to fill me with your Spirit, to begin a relationship with you right in my heart. For Lord, I ask these things, giving you thanks. In Jesus' name, amen.
It's not just a story, it's a living, breathing, walking testimony of a God so good he'd leave his home and glory for the world he loved, for the world that he so loved. Oh, it's not just a story, no. Help me say it, y'all. I believe in the life of Jesus.
From the very beginning, Jesus planned to come to earth as a child to live among us. He healed the sick, and he died to save all those who would believe. He rose again from the dead, crushing the head of Satan and defeating death. He promises that he will come again. Yes, he will come again in power and glory, to claim the earth as his kingdom. For those who have heard and responded to the heartbeat of love, the second coming of Christ will be a long-awaited time of peace and redemption. This Christmas, as you gather together with your family and your friends, take time to remember the heartbeat and the love of Jesus. His love is greater than we could ever fathom.
Gonna be okay. Ooh, yeah. It doesn't scare me. It's temporary. There's something better we got forever. And it won't be long, cause we know our help is on the way. The way.
So keep your head up.
The day or time, no. The trumpet's gonna blow and the skies are gonna open wide. Yeah, he's coming for us just like he told us. It's been a long wait, but there's a new day. We're gonna sing hallelujah when the king arrives.